Hey YouTube, welcome to Whacky Deck Wednesday. This is something new that I wanted to try out. I will probably be making like wacky and fun decks to try on Wednesdays. These aren't going to be the most competitive decks, but that doesn't mean that you can't win with them. The whole purpose of Whacky Wednesday is just to enjoy the games and maybe enjoy some of the less played cards out there. So for our first wacky deck, it's going to be a full trigger Big Mom deck. So every card in this deck has trigger, so when you take life, expect some trigger to happen, and that is why I have given this deck the name Triggered Mom. Get it? Anyways, now I said a fully triggered deck, but that's not 100% right. Yeah, sorry, I lied, sad face. Actually, out of the 50 cards in this deck, only 8 don't have triggers. So really, about 84% of the deck are triggers. So chances are you will be triggering about 80% of the time at least, which isn't bad at all. So what are the 8 cards that don't have triggers? That's right, you probably guessed it. They're the Big Mama cards. So why are we running Big Moms? Well, because they're new cards and they're fun, duh. But actually, this deck kind of needs him to win, so yeah. And also, besides, it's kind of fun to just trash your opponent's life without having to give them any cards, right? So there is that. So how do you play this deck? Well, you control the board with your minions that you get off trigger, like Peril Sparrow, Cracker, or Smoothie. Your leader card can also help you clear the board and get your life if you start to get low. Napoleon helps buff your leader to clear easier while also giving you a boost during your opponent's turn, which is pretty nice. It's like becoming like Whitebeard for a turn. Event cards like Thunderbolt and Shockwave will also help you clear the board. So really what you want to make sure is that you stay at a healthy amount of life for turn 7 and turn 10, which are your Big Mom plays. So gameplay strategy, getting your opponent to 0 life. So the fun part of yellow is being able to trash your opponent's life without hitting them. The 10 cost Big Mom does this while also giving you an extra life. The 7 cost Big Mom either gives you life or trashes a life from your opponent. Pretty much your opponent chooses their poison. If your opponent chooses to give you life instead of trashing their life, then you'll start pushing some damage to face with your leaders or character. But at this point, your 7 cost Big Mom should be on the field putting pressure on. But generally, the rule of thumb is to trash as much life from your effects as you can, just in order to deny your opponent some cards. So if I haven't mentioned it before, so this deck is running the black and yellow Big Mom leader card, so you have access to some of the really strong like trigger effects from black. But yeah, I mean, you kind of want to start controlling the board, stay healthy, and then use your effects to trash your opponent's life. And when you can't, and once you have your Big Moms on the field, you have your big minions on the field, then you can start pushing whatever life they have left. That's generally the strategy. You know, it's pretty simple. You have to high roll a lot, which is what makes this deck very fun, by the way. That's the whole point of just having all of these triggers, is just to see what you get and see if you can even like out tempo your opponent through these triggers, clear board through these triggers, or even get a life off of these triggers with Soul Pocus. So that's what makes it really fun in my opinion. So what are the weaknesses of this deck? Pretty much any decent deck. I'm just playing, but well, kind of. Part of the fun is seeing what triggers you get from your life. So this deck isn't exactly the most consistent deck there is. That's why, you know, consistent decks will always do better, but that doesn't mean this deck can high roll with some good triggers that let you all temple your opponent. Anyways, if you want to have like some Russian roulette fun, or you're one of those players that are, you know, just RNGs constantly favors, which I hate you, by the way, then just give this deck a try. You know, it'll definitely, you know, just confuse your opponents. It's fun to play this at locals. I probably wouldn't take this to like a regionals or an online tournament, you know, unless you just want to troll your opponents. And honestly, this is such a really good troll deck, you know, just it makes your opponent think twice about whether they want to attack you or not, because he knows trigger's probably going to happen. But yeah, I mean, in all seriousness, this deck is not consistent at all. But some of the triggers that you get is just so much fun. Being able to see your opponent's reactions from every time they hit your life and something happens, it's great. So definitely try this at your locals and have fun with it, and you know, maybe get some wins. So anyways, hope you enjoyed this deck. Here's the full deck list. Feel free to stick around for some gameplay that I'll be providing, just to see some of the wacky stuff that this deck can build. So I hope you guys like this idea, especially for my first Whacky Wednesday deck. If you guys like it, I'll keep doing more. And just let me know what you guys think in your comments and or your ideas in the comments. Yeah, anyways, hope you guys enjoy your OP-03 openings, your pre-releases, and have a good one, and see you in the next video.
Thank you.